Don't miss it.
A lot of fuel trays.
Thanks, Carl. Over the years, we've brought you many stories on the fate of Australian-made and owned products. And generally, the news has not been good. We've seen plenty of Aussie brands sold offshore. Well, tonight, one of our oldest Australian names has been saved from extinction. Gather it in,
bring it on home. Rosella was around before we were a nation. They say its name was born from the birds that flew over the yard where it was made. But a few months back, it seemed 120 years of history was about to come to an end.
People are sad, but what can you do?
Rosella went into receivership and looked like disappearing altogether, or going the same way as other iconic brands, falling into the hands of foreign-owned multinationals.
We wanted to make sure that it remained in Australia.
Well, finally some good news in the manufacturing industry. That glass bottle with the bird on it is back on the production line.
I can remember having it as a kid, and as a kid, I never thought when I grew up that I'd own it one day.
New owner Dan Presser reckons the soup, sauce and chutney will mean jobs for all.
In factories, for farmers, for cardboard producers, and we're keeping it all here in Australia.
Tastes just like the soup my mum used to make.
The recipes actually came from my great-grandmother's kitchen initially.
That was back in 1895, says John Coom.
During the Second World War, it was even provided to the American troops.
In a sea of supermarket sauce, Dick Smith and Rosella are waving the Aussie flag, which means Alf Garnett won't be back.
It's Rosella soup. I opened the can myself.
Can? Oh, I'm not eating no can muck.
Some things have exceeded their use-by date.
Oh.
But this one lives to see another day.
And who knows, Rosella could again become an international brand and we could show the rest of the world what we can do in Australia.
Next, the